Hello friends, now in this lecture we will start new chapter, that is algebraic identities. Okay, so before I give you the question related to this, we will quickly revise about the identities. So here is the very first identity, well known identity, that is a plus b whole square, a square plus b square plus 2ab. Some people do write a square plus 2ab plus b square is the same thing. Second is a minus b whole square, that is a square plus b square minus 2ab. Third is a square minus b square, that is equal to a plus b into a minus b. Okay, so better to write in this way, a plus b multiplied by a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. Fourth one is a plus b whole cube, that is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. Then fifth one is a minus b whole cube, that is a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. Sixth one is okay, next onward I am writing over here. Sixth one is a cube plus b cube, that is a plus b a square plus b square minus ab. Okay, a cube plus b cube. Now we have one more identity of a cube plus b cube, so I do write this as sixth a and then sixth b. Again I can write a cube plus b cube is equal to a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b whole cube, a plus b whole cube minus 3ab a plus b. Okay, now seventh a. Now a cube minus b cube is a minus b. Okay, then a square plus b square plus ab. Then seventh b. As I have two identities for a cube plus b cube, similarly I have two identities for a cube minus b cube. A cube minus b cube, that is a minus b whole cube plus 3ab a minus b. Okay, after that next identity I can write as a plus b plus c whole square, that is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. Okay, then if I write one more identity here, I can write a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is equal to a plus b plus c. Here a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca. Okay, and the last identity, that is 10th, that is the conditional identity. See, we have so many variation in this identity as well as okay, so that we'll discuss first of all completing all the identities. So next 10th identity is if a plus b plus c equal to 0, this is known as conditional identity. See, in this identity a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to a plus b plus c. I'm replacing this a plus b plus c equal to 0. If I make it 0, 0 multiplied by whatever becomes 0. That means if a plus b plus c is 0, the right hand side becomes 0. And then I can take this minus 3abc on that side. So I can say then a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc. Okay, so these are the 10 identities on which we will see the questions. So first of all, note down these identities, then I will discuss this identity once again, because there are eight different variations in this identity. This one is the basic one, and remaining we'll see that if I change the sign, then what will be the result. So first of all, note it down, then we'll come to this identity once again. Okay, so I hope you noted down these identities. Okay, so see, I'll give you a short way by which you can remember the identity. See, here I have, these are the three basic identities, so I'm not going to discuss these. Still, one thing that can be discussed in that, see, this is a plus b whole square, so a square plus b square plus 2ab, as the plus sign is there, so I took plus 2ab. Okay, and these are the squares, so cannot be negative. Now similarly, this a square plus b square minus 2ab, these two cannot be negative because they are complete square, and because there is minus sign, so we'll put minus sign over here, minus 2ab. Now a plus b multiplied by a minus b, that means product of sum and difference is difference of their squares, a square minus b square. Now a plus b whole cube, so a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. So cube of first, cube of second, then 3 times of these two multiplied by the a plus b. Now if you remember this one, then you can find this by your own. See, simply what I did, except the first term, remaining all term become negative. Or in other word, you can see here b is positive, here b is negative. So wherever we find b in this identity, if you take it negative, we'll get the identity. So instead of plus b cube, so it become minus b cube. So here it is b, so minus sign, so minus 3ab. Here again b is positive, but here it is negative, so I'll put minus sign, so this will become a minus b. I'm giving you way so that you can easily remember these identities. Now a cube plus b cube is a plus b. Whenever you have find the identity of a cube plus b cube, remember one thing, that there will be one minus sign throughout the identity. As it is plus, so first bracket remains plus, then a square plus b square. As I told you, one minus sign should be there. Now as this is plus, so first bracket become plus over here, and these are the complete square, cannot be negative, so definitely minus sign go with this last term, that is minus ab. Similarly, a cube minus b cube, because of minus, this first bracket become negative. Now as I told you that only one sign can be there in a plus b whole cube or a minus b whole cube, minus sign is over here, so no minus sign will come again, or it won't get repeat. Okay, now if we discuss about this a cube plus b cube, this actually I obtained from this. See, I need to get the value of a cube plus b cube, so what I did, I took this term over here, so this will become a plus b whole cube minus 3ab a plus b, isn't it? This is plus, so I took that side, so this will become negative, so I obtained this a cube plus b cube actually from this. Similarly, I obtained this a cube minus b cube from this. If I take this minus 3ab into a minus b on this side, I will get a minus b whole cube plus 3ab into a minus b. Now a plus b plus c whole square, so square of all three plus 2 multiplied by taken 2 at a time, that means 2 into AB, then 2 into BC, then 2 into CA. ओके विद प्लस साइन, देन ए क्यूब प्लस बी क्यूब प्लस सी क्यूब माइनस 3ABC, सो ए प्लस बी प्लस सी, ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस सी स्क्वायर माइनस ए बी माइनस बी सी माइनस सी. नाउ बेस्ड ऑन दिस वी हैव द आइडेंटिटी नंबर 10th, कंडीशनल आइडेंटिटी. दैट मीन्स इफ द कंडीशन दैट सम ऑफ थ्री क्वांटिटीज इज जीरो, ओके सो राइट हैंड साइड बिकम जीरो, सो आई कैन टेक दिस माइनस 3ABC ऑन दैट साइड, सो आई विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ ए क्यूब प्लस बी क्यूब प्लस सी क्यूब. ओके सो नाउ as I told you, we'll discuss the remaining 7 versions of this particular identity 8. So let us see. See, I have the very basic version, that is a plus b plus c whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. Okay, now see, when I say 8 version, that means I can change the sign. Suppose if I make these two negative, this will and I keep it as it is, that means positive. If I make these two negative and I keep it this as it is, or I make all three negative, in that way I will get different version. So first let me discuss this. Suppose I make these two negative, then what will be the identity? Definitely it won't be the same, there will be some changes. Now how to find those changes and also how to write the identity with this change in the sign? You have to mug up only first this original form, no need to mug up the remaining 7. Just you have to understand that how you have to write the correct side, right side, as per the change in the sign. See, simply if you have a square plus b square plus c square, so what I actually did, I make b negative and c negative. So a square, now instead of b, right now I have minus b. So if I do like this, and here if I do like this, so I am putting the value in the original identity with the sign. So b I kept as minus b, c I replaced by minus c. Similarly, I will do over here 2 into a into minus b plus 2 into minus b into c plus 2 into c into 2 into minus c into a, 2 into a b b c and c a, 2 into minus c into a. Okay, so this a square, now minus b square is b square plus c square is c square. That means even though b, c, or suppose a is also negative, first three terms I will get always a square plus b square plus c square, because when it was positive, definitely its square will be b square. If even though if I take it negative sign, then again it will become positive b square only. So I can say first three terms in all 8 versions remains a square plus b square plus c square only. Now over here minus a into minus b, so I can write minus 2ab because b is negative, ab then bc. Here I can write minus 2c, here c is also negative, okay, c is also negative, so I should write in this way actually. So plus 2bc, this remains plus 2bc, minus minus plus, and again it will become minus 2ac. So just based on the sign I can write, see here b was negative, so I took minus 2ab, b and c both are negative, so this will become positive, c is negative, a is positive, so ultimately this term will become negative. Okay, so square of a minus b minus c is this, a square plus b square plus c square minus 2ab plus 2bc minus 2c. Okay, now let us see one more version. If I take minus a plus b minus c whole square, so as I told you, first three terms are definitely going to be positive only, because if I take minus a whole square, ultimately it will become a square. Then plus b square, so it will be b square. Then plus minus c whole square, that is again c square. Okay, now नेक्स्ट इज प्लस टू ए बी, सो प्लस टू ए बी, सो प्लस एंड देर इज वन नेगेटिव साइन, सो आई कैन डायरेक्टली राइट माइनस टू ए बी. देन प्लस टू बी सी, सो अगेन प्लस टू बी सी, सो वन इज नेगेटिव साइन, सो अगेन इट विल बिकम माइनस टू बी सी. एंड वेन आई डू राइट प्लस टू ए सी, बोथ आर नेगेटिव, सो दैट विल बिकम पॉजिटिव टू ए सी. सो यू कैन ऑल्सो सी दैट इफ वन टर्म इज नेगेटिव, a was negative, so combination of this becomes negative. C is negative, so combination of this becomes negative. Both are negative, so that will become positive. So in that way, you can write all the different versions of this identity. Let us discuss one more. If I say minus a minus b plus c whole square, so first three terms are going to be again complete square. Minus a whole square gives you only a square. Minus b whole square gives you b square. Plus c whole square gives you c square. Now, 2 into a into b, both are negative, so this will become positive. Then 2 into b into c, one is negative, one is positive, so that will become 2bc. Okay, then again 2 into a into c, one is negative, one is positive, so minus 2ac. So simply you have to check, if both are negative, make it positive. If both are positive, but overall it will be positive. If one term is negative, one is positive, then it will be negative. So in that way, we can write all the different versions using the first one only. So no need to mug up all these. Simply concentrate on this and write these three terms. See, first three terms are definitely going to be positive. You have to write remaining three terms based on the sign. Okay. So please note it down. Then we'll start the questions based on these identities. Okay, so let us see a question based on this, these identities. Okay, so here is the very first question. If x plus y is equal to 12, plus y is equal to 12 and xy is equal to 27, find the value of x cube plus y cube. Okay, now there are two ways to solve this type of question. See, first thing, we can go for hidden trial. That means we can think about two numbers whose sum is whose product is 27. So here I can say 9 plus 3 is 12, 9 into 3 is 27, that means I can say x equal to 9, y is equal to 3, and just by keeping those values in this, I will get its value. But suppose you will get this type of question in your subjective part, then how you have to solve? So here we have to find the value of x cube plus y cube. So first of all, I do write the identity of x cube plus y cube, that is a cube plus b cube. So a cube plus b cube is a plus b. Okay, we have two identities. We do write both the identities and then we'll decide that by using which identity it will be easy to find its value. So the identity is a plus b, a square plus b square minus ab. And the second identity of a cube plus b cube is a plus b whole cube minus 3ab a plus b. Okay. Now, if I use this identity, so I need this x plus y, which is given directly, no issues. Now, when another now I need x square plus y square. Xy is given directly, but I need x square plus y square to get the value of x cube plus y cube. So to obtain x cube plus y cube, I need external one more information, that x square plus y square, that is not given. So first of all, I have to obtain that. But if I skip this and I come to the second identity, here I have x plus y whole cube. That means x plus y is given. X into y, that is also given. X plus y, that is also given. That means only with the given information it is possible to obtain the value of x cube plus y cube. So I will go with this. Okay, so let us see. Therefore, I can say x cube plus y cube is equal to, now x plus y is 12. Now in this case, you must know the value of 12 cube. Okay, minus 3 into xy, that is 27. And again x plus y, that is 12. So here the only thing that left is the calculation part. So do this calculation and find the final answer. This gives you x cube plus y cube is equal to 1728. Okay, 12 cube is 1728 minus, now over there we can multiply 27 into 3, that is 81 multiplied by 12. So ultimately x cube plus y cube is equal to 1728 minus 8 minus 2 is 6, 12 minus 7 is 5, 16 minus 9 is 7, 756. Okay, 756 is the answer. And the first method that we saw, we can justify or we can verify our answer. See, here I took x equal to 9, y equal to 3, because x equal to 9 and y equal to 3 is satisfying the equation. So according to that, answer should be 9 cube plus 3 cube. Now 9 cube is 729 and 3 cube is 9. So there is a difference between these two answers. Cube is 27. Okay, I took 3 cube as 9. So 9 plus 7, 16, 6, carry 1, 5, and this, yes, answer is same. It should be same only. Even though the method is different, answer should be same. So here, by mistake, I took 3 cube as 9. That's why I was getting incorrect answer. Okay, so please note it down. Then we'll see the next question. Now let us see the next question. Okay, next question is, if x minus y equal to 4, x minus y is equal to 4, x into y equal to 21, देन फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स क्यूब माइनस वाई क्यूब. ओके सो अगेन इट्स वेरी इजी. सी क्लियरली वी कैन सी इफ आई टेक एक्स इक्वल टू 7 वाई इक्वल टू 3 सो 7 माइनस 3 इज 4 7 इंटू 3 इज 21. सो हेयर आई कैन राइट 7 क्यूब माइनस 3 क्यूब दैट गिव्स यू माय आंसर. बट वील ऑल्सो सी इफ आई हैव टू फाइंड द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दिस बाय फॉर सब्जेक्टिव पार्ट देन इट शुड बी एक्स माइनस वाई होल क्यूब इज एक्स एक्स क्यूब माइनस वाई क्यूब इज एक्स माइनस वाई होल क्यूब प्लस 3 एक्स वाई एक्स माइनस वाई. ओके सो एक्स क्यूब माइनस वाई क्यूब इज एक्स माइनस वाई इज 4 4 क्यूब प्लस 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 21 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 4. सो एक्स क्यूब माइनस वाई क्यूब इज इक्वल टू 64 प्लस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 4. सो एक्स क्यूब माइनस वाई क्यूब इज 64 प्लस 252. So ultimately x cube minus y cube is going to be 4 plus 2 6, 5 plus 6 11, 3 1 6. Okay, so we'll also verify with our answer by keeping the values of x as 7 and y as 3. So 7 cube minus 3 cube. 7 cube is 343, 3 cube is 27. So 13 minus 7 is 6, 3 minus 2 is 1 and 3. So we are getting the same answer. Definitely we will get the same answer because the question is same. Okay, so please note it down. Then we will see the next question. Okay, now we will see the next question. Okay, so next question is if x plus 1 upon x is equal to 6. X plus 1 upon x equal to 6, find the value of x square plus 1 upon x square and x raised to 4 plus 1 upon x raised to 4. Okay, you have to find these two values. Okay, I'm giving you the mixed question. I'm not giving you the question identity wise. First we solve the question containing having identities a cube plus b cube, and over here we can see there are a square, that means it is the identity of a plus b whole square. So let us see how to solve this. See, we need x square plus 1 upon x square and also x raised to 4 plus 1 upon x raised to 4. So also we know identity of a plus b whole square is a square plus b square plus 2ab, but for a while if I say a plus b whole square, that means a square and b square. That means to get the square on two terms, we have to apply the identity of a plus b whole square. So to get the value of x square plus 1 square, we have to start with this. And when we make square on both sides, definitely we'll get these two terms. We'll get one extra term, but definitely we'll get this term. So let us see how to start. See, we have x plus 1 upon x is equal to 6. So squaring both sides, if I make this square on both sides, what I will get? Here definitely I will get 36. And here I can apply the identity of a plus b whole square. On applying that identity, I will get a square plus b square. Isn't it? Square of first quantity, square of second quantity, plus 2 into a into b. This dot represents the multiplication. Instead of multiplication, I use dot. Is equal to 36. Now you can see this x and x will cancel out. And this is the expression whose value to find. So what I will do, I do write this as it is, and this 2, because here only 2 is remaining, and this 2, if I take on that side, I will get 36 minus 2. So here, say I obtain the final value, that is x square plus 1 upon x square is equal to 34. So this is my final answer for the first one. Now we need to get the value of this. So now as I hope you can observe that to get this, I squared this. So to get this, I have to make the square of this. Now I have the value of this. So I will start with this by squaring. So now x square plus 1 upon x square is equal to 34. Therefore, I can write x square plus 1 upon x square whole square is equal to 34 whole square. Okay, so definitely when you apply the identity of a plus b whole square over here and 34 square, you will get the value of x raised to 4 plus 1 upon x raised to 4. So try to solve it further and try to get the value of required expression. Then I will give you its final solution. Okay, so here I can apply the identity of a plus b whole square. So a square plus b square plus 2 into a into b is equal to 1156. 1156. So this gives you x raised to 4 plus 1 upon x raised to 4 is equal to, now this x square will cancel out, this 1, this 2 when I take on that side will become 1156 minus 2. So ultimately x raised to 4 plus 1 upon x raised to 4 is equal to 1154. Now in the previous two questions when we have to find the value of x cube plus y cube, it was easy to identify the values of x and y, but here it is little bit difficult to identify the value of x. Okay, here we have to use this method only. There isn't any shortcut method for this. So note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, now we will see the next question. Okay, next question is if x square plus 1 upon x square plus 1 upon x square is equal to 27, then you have to find the value of x plus 1 upon x and x minus 1 upon x. So we can say this is almost reverse of that concept over there. X plus 1 upon x was given and they were asking this. Now here x square plus 1 upon x square is given and we have to find the value of x plus 1 and x minus 1 upon x. Okay, so let us see how to solve this type of question. See, now we need this. Okay, so we'll start with this x plus 1 upon x whole square. I am applying the directly identity. So can I say this is x square plus 1 upon x square plus 2 into x into 1 upon x. Okay, I started with this. That means identity of x a plus b whole square. So I wrote a square plus b square plus 2ab. So therefore I can write x plus 1 upon x whole square is equal to, now this value is given to us, isn't it? X square plus 1 upon x square is given 27. This x and x I can cancel, so here I can write 2. So from this I can get the value of x plus 1 upon x whole square is equal to 29. So that gives me value of x plus 1 upon x, that is plus minus root 29. Whenever you find the square root, you have to keep both the sign, positive as well as negative. So value of x plus 1 upon x is equal to plus minus root 29. Now we need to find the value of x minus 1 upon x. So almost in a similar way, I can start with x minus 1 upon x whole square. So that gives me x square plus 1 upon x square, and instead of plus 2x upon 1 upon x, I will get minus over here. Okay, so let us see how to get that. Now, x minus 1 upon x whole square is equal to x square plus 1 upon x square minus 2 into x into 1 upon x. Okay, x square plus 1 upon x square minus 2 into a into b. So this gives you x minus 1 upon x whole square. Now at the place of x square plus 1 upon x square, I can put 27 minus 2. This x and x will cancel out. So here I do get x minus 1 upon x whole square is equal to 25. Now again, to get the value of x minus 1 upon x, I have to take square root. That gives me plus minus root 25, that is equal to 5. See, over here it was not the perfect square, so I kept it like as it is. But over here it is possible to find the square root of, see, it is also possible to find the square root of 29. But here I can say the given term has is a complete square. So as it is a complete square, so I do find its square root, and that is plus minus 5. Square root of 25 is 5. So final answer of value of x minus 1 upon x is plus minus 5. Okay, so please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, so now let us see the next question. Okay, next question is, if x plus y equal to 12, if x plus y is equal to 12 and xy equal to 32, xy is equal to 32, then find the value of x square plus y square, or find the value of x square plus y square as well as x square minus y square. Okay, so again, if I try to get the values of x and y by hit and try, this might be 8 and 4, because 8 plus 4 is 12 and 8 into 4 is 32. So if I use that way, it is very easy to get their values. Just I have to put the values of x and y in this to get these answers. But if I have to solve it in a proper way, that is for a subjective part, then how I have to solve, let us see. I need x square plus y square, and this is a part of the identity of x plus y whole square. So I do start from there only. X plus y is equal to 12. Therefore, here I can write x plus y whole square. That means squaring both sides. So this gives me x square plus y square plus 2xy is equal to 144. Now x square plus y square, that I have to obtain. This is the required value. So I keep it as it is, and at the place of xy, that is 32, I put 32 is equal to 144. So here I can get x square plus y square plus 64 is equal to 144. So ultimately, x square plus y square is going to be 144 minus 64, that is 80. This is the value of x square plus y square. Okay, this is the value of x square plus y square. Now, how to get the value of x square minus y square? Okay, before I proceed to get the value of x square minus y square, let me confirm whether this value is right or not by keeping x equal to 8 and y equal to 4, because we got those values by hit and trial, because those two values are satisfying these two given information, x equal to 8, y equal to 4, or vice versa. Whether, because here we haven't any information whether x is greater than y or x is less than y. So it might be x equal to 8 or it might be y equal to 8. So now x square plus y square, that is 8 square plus 4 square, 64 plus 16, yes, this is 80. Okay, so we can say it is definitely correct. However, no need to verify, but as we have two methods, that's why we are verifying the values. Now, how to get the value of x square minus y square? See, as I started with x plus y whole square, so I got, because I was knowing that x square y square is part of this identity, but x square minus y square is not a part of x minus y whole square. So to get the value of x square minus y square, see, I have x plus y into x minus y. That means product of these two gives me x square minus y square. Now, among these two, this is given directly. X plus y is given 12. It means to get the value of x square minus y square, I need to find x minus y. And x minus y I can find by squaring and then by taking a square root. Okay, so first now I will find the value of x minus y. Now, how to get the value of x minus y? That if I make the square, so I will get x square plus y square minus 2xy. Isn't it? Now, see, I have x minus y whole square. So definitely I can get x minus y as well. Now, x square, to get the value of x minus y whole square, I need x square plus y square, that is already obtained. So I put वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वाई स्क्वायर इज 80 ओवर हियर माइनस 2 एंड एक्स वाई इज 32. सो हियर आई डू गेट एक्स माइनस वाई होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 80 माइनस 64. देयरफॉर आई विल गेट एक्स माइनस वाई होल स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 16 एंड हेंस आई विल गेट एक्स माइनस वाई इज इक्वल टू प्लस माइनस 4. नाउ हियर सी जस्ट राइट नाउ I told you that we do not know whether x is greater than y or y is greater than x. So this plus minus sign shows that only. If I take x is greater than y, it will be positive. If I take x is less than y, it will be negative. So there are two possible values of x minus y. Okay. If the this complete information, I give you one more information, that is x is less than y, then definitely it will be minus 4. But this information is not given, so I have to consider both the values of x minus y. Okay, now what actually I have to find? X square minus y square, isn't it? X square minus y square, and x square minus y square is equal to, see, now x square minus y square is equal to x plus y x minus y. Therefore x square minus y square is now x plus y we already obtained. X plus y is not obtained, it is given actually. So x plus y I keep 12 and at the place of x minus y I do put this plus minus 4. So here final value of therefore x square minus y square is equal to plus minus 48. Okay, plus minus 48, this is the value of x square minus y square. Now, as I told you initially that it is possible to get the value of x and y by hit and trial. So let us see whether the x square minus y square is equal to plus minus 48 or not by the value that we obtained. What we had x equal to 8 and y equal to 4 or vice versa. So square minus y square, that is 8 square minus 4 square, that is 64 minus 16, okay, plus 48, because I took x equal to 8. As I told you, we do not have any idea whether x is greater than y or vice versa. That means when I took x equal to 8, I got plus 48. Now if I take x equal to 4, then definitely I will get 16 minus 48, that is equal to minus 48, okay, 16 minus 48, I will get 16 minus 64, that is minus 48, and over here 64 minus 16, okay, 64 minus 16, so positive 48, negative 48, so that's why there are two values of x square minus, here just I verified those values, so no need to note it down, just it is for your understanding that it is possible to get those two values which I got by a formula. We can get the same values by putting the values of x and y. So please note it down, then we'll see the next question. Okay, now we'll see the next question. If 3x plus 2y equal to 12, if 3x plus 2y is equal to 12, xy is equal to 6, then find the value of 9x square plus 4y square. 9x square plus 4y square. Okay, so let us see its solution. 3x plus 2y equal to 12, xy equal to 9. Now, if you observe carefully, this 9x is actually square of 3x and this 4y is actually square of 2y. That means we can say that this particular expression is definitely lies in the square of this. Okay, as the first a square and b square. So, we'll start with that only. 3x plus 2y is equal to 12. Now, we'll make a square of both sides. So, this will become 3x plus 2y whole square is equal to 12 square. Okay, so this gives you a square plus b square plus 2 into a into b is equal to 144. Now, this 3x whole square gives you 9x square. 2y whole square gives you 4y square. Now, that is the expression whose value we have to obtain. Now, over here, 2 into 3 into 2, that is 12xy is equal to 144. Now, it means to obtain the value of this expression, we need the value of this expression. Now, to get the value of this expression, we just need the value of x multiplied by, that is xy, and which is given in the question directly. So, simply what I will do, I put xy equal to 6 over here. So, this gives you 9x square plus 4y square plus 12 into 6 is equal to 144. Okay, so it is almost done. Simply I have to multiply and I have to take this over there. So, this gives you 9x square plus 4y square plus 72 is equal to 144. So, ultimately, here I will get my answer 144 minus 72, that is 72 only. So, 9x square plus 4y square is equal to 72. So, this is my final answer. Now, suppose if I say in the same question, you have to find the value of 9x square minus 4y square. In the same, if I say find the value of 9x square minus 4y square, then how you will do? Okay, 9x square minus 4y square. Okay, so first of all note it down, then we'll see that how to get the value of 9x square minus 4y square. So, let us see how to get that value. See, before I proceed, let me explain you one thing. See, 9x square minus 4y square can be written as 3x whole square minus 2y whole square. Now, here you can see we can apply the identity of a square minus b square. That is 3x plus 2y, 3x minus 2y. It means to obtain this, we need this as well as this. Now, to obtain this, we need 3x plus 2y, which is given directly. Next, we need 3x minus 2y. So, here, our first target is to obtain the value of 3x minus 2y, and that I will start with the same only. Okay, So let us see how to get that value 3x minus 2y. So I will start with this. Now 3x minus 2y whole square is equal to 9x square plus 4y square minus 2 into 3x into 2y minus 2ab, isn't it? So 3x minus 2y whole square is equal to, now I need this value which is 72, I obtained over here, isn't it? 9x square plus 4y square is equal to 72. So I use this value. So here I put 72 minus 12xy. So 3x minus 2y whole square is equal to 72 minus 12 into 6. xy is equal to 6, it is already given. So 3x minus 2y whole square is equal to 72 minus 72. That means here I can say 3x minus 2 to 0. Okay. So value of 3x minus 2y is equal to 0. Here I got this value 0. That means 9x square minus 4y square actually becomes 0. Isn't it? Here 3x minus 2y is equal to 0. Now what I have to find? I have to find 9x square minus 4y square. So now 9x square minus 4y square is equal to 3x whole square minus 2y whole square. Therefore 9x square minus 4y square is equal to 3x plus 2y, 3x minus 2y. Therefore 9x square minus 4y square is equal to, now value of 3x plus 2y is 12 and value of 3x minus 2y is 0. So here I can say 9x square minus 4y square is equal to 0. Okay, so please note it down. Okay, so that is all about this lecture. Now we'll meet in next lecture. We'll see some more question on same concept. Till then, bye. Thank you. Take care. Stay at home.